I've come to Rahoy. It is a surprise of beauty. But when I come here, I sense more than a beauty. It's a deep homecoming, a welcoming feeling. I could swear the hills of Rahoy have open arms, as if they're reaching out for me, guiding me, wanting to welcome me in. There's a feeling of peace and calm. I've been here a few days now, and I'm beginning to relax. It's a feeling of encircling warmth. More and more. I feel it like a kiss, a caress. And I feel myself responding to it, wanting to gently enter gentleness. What am I experiencing? It's the power of slowness, slowing down. Reminded of that poem by Gerard Manley Hopkins. It says, the world is charged with the grandeur of God. It will flame out like shining from shook foil. Well, it's not flaming out. More like the power of slowing. It's got something to do with not thinking. It's freedom from my usual organising and planning. My mind has simply stopped those things. They're just not happening. I start to feel really free. But I don't think about that either. All I know is this confidence in this moment. Lightness inside and out. I've been slowed down by a power. Call it God. Call it the power of slowing. Call it what you like.
In the coolness of the autumn morning, sense the absolute mercy being, of absolute being. Moving into my willingness, opening my desire, deepening my relaxation, empowering my vulnerability, making me receptive to what is. I think God respects our individual integrity and won't invade us when and where we are unwelcoming. I bet seals could teach us a lot about just being.
My theory is that life needs 95% openness and 5% concentration. We've kind of got things back to front.
To quote William Blake, to see the world in a grain of sand, heaven in a wildflower, hold infinity in the palm of your hand, and eternity in an hour. Not bad, that. I wish we could encourage our children's natural contemplative awareness, as well as concentration. To look at the colours of the leaves and the rock pools. All it takes is something or someone to point us in the right direction. And then, when we look there, we discover teachers everywhere. Inside trees, animals and rocks, and locks, and in our own souls. The human soul is born in love, but it doesn't see the one it loves. That one is reflected in all created things, and so we cling to them. Every soul is created for love. This was the restlessness which filled St. Augustine's heart until he finally understood for whom his heart yearned and whom he loved. God is within the great feeling of solitude with which we are all born, along with the consciousness that there exists a partner. And this friend is within us, in our secret self.